Today, on Local Fishing Legends, we're going to test a ton of techniques on Perth Samsonfish to help you become an expert on jigging. But not all of them are winners.
We can't stop these things today.
I've seen a lot of TV shows about Samsonfish, and I've read even more. What I've noticed is that very few people agree on exactly what tackle and technique works best for this amazing sport fish from the southwest of Australia. So today, we were lucky enough to have a 9-metre leisure cat at our disposal, along with one of my instructors, a jigging fanatic called Andrew. And we're going to work out once and for all what the average person needs to go jigging. Well, obviously the first thing you need is a boat. And while we were leaving Woodman's Point in something the size of a small planet, you can get by with a vessel around 6 metres, which will get you out to the 100 metre line. This is because sambos live around wrecks and deep reefs in big numbers, so you have to pick your day carefully. Seabreeze.com.au told us that we weren't going to have a big window, just the morning to land some 10 to 15 kilo fish and try a bunch of different ideas and techniques. The wind direction was going to be easterly, blowing off the shore, and that's exactly what you want to get out to the wrecks. So I decided on one that's been excellent for us in the past, with fish that aren't too big to handle quickly and pretty much no sharks. However, I learned from making TV shows and doing fishing lessons, it's amazing just how different a day can turn out.
What do you think? No, not yet. What about now? Oh, now.
Here we go.
Off you go. Apparently, as it hits the ground, it will coincide miraculously with the fish being right there. That's what Paul tells us. And you know what? I'm tending not to doubt him these days. So you're not a spinning reel man yourself, obviously.
Overhead man.
Yeah, me too. You do have a pretty dazzling array of gear there. The rib knobbler, for example.
More grip.
More grip, apparently. That's what they tell me. Are you there yet? You need bigger jigs. That looked like splashdown. All right. I'm getting bored. Hurry up. So now you go right to the bottom.
Right to the bottom.
And then let's see this technique. So you give it a little one and then a big one, no?
Just a couple little.
Everyone's technique varies so much. I'm always quite interested to see it. It's not working. You don't have one. Now, after you've jigged up a certain distance from the bottom, and your sounder will tell you where you think the fish are, literally. If you think, well, I've gone 10, 20, 30 metres up, don't bring it all the way to the top. You'll just end up killing yourself. Drop it straight back down, start again. The first drift sometimes just gets them excited if they're not feeding. I'm running out of things to say. Hurry up and catch one. He chopped it, and Paul goes, I'm just going over him. You reckon you've probably gone above the school now, so you want to drop back down into it? Just a little bit, you saw that? Just a few metres. Well, I tell you what, Andrew, aside from the caraman almost going over the side of the boat there, you've got yourself a decent Samson fish here, haven't you?
Yep.
Andrew's way of handling sambos is with heavy tackle. 80-pound braid, short, stiff rods, and enough pressure to keep the fish moving upwards whenever possible.
You've been tightening that drag wheel up a lot. And more! He's gone 3 Titans. This is actually not a bad fish, is it? Now, your braid, what are you using there specifically?
80-pound braid.
Any particular brand you like?
Jinkoi.
Yeah.
120-pound suffix leader.
I don't think this one's getting away. Might be a different case when I ever go because I'm a little bit more sporting than that. Ooh, it's a long haul and a long way down. What do you think about while you're hauling this in? Is it the pain? Is it the excitement?
The sharks.
The sharks. Well, yes, there's that. Although, I don't reckon I hardly ever see a shark on this particular spot. And we've got it to ourselves today. Normally it's like hay street out here.
Look at that swirl of sound. That is at least 30 to 50 metres
deep. Oh, we're going to have some fun. Are you done yet? Actually, I don't mind. I love seeing someone having fun. You'll also notice that Andrew is only lifting his rod no more than 45 degrees at a time. He's not taking it from the ground and lifting it up, trying to shoot starlings. He's just lifting it up a little bit using the backbone. And I see colour. Do you want to bring it over to the patented leisure cat patio? First one for the day. In the bugger grips. And then we'll just treat him gently. And believe it or not, well, there's the camera. If you're not from Perth, this is a small one, wouldn't you say?
Very small.
And the bugger grips say 33 pounds.
33,
I think. That's 15 kilos.
You'll notice that we don't lay the fish on the deck, which is hot, because it's going straight back in.
So we've changed Andrew's jig to a release weight. We could probably swim him and get him back that way, but we're just going to walk him to the back of the boat. I almost fell in then. That was really, really embarrassing. So bugger grips out. Free spool.
Yep.
Down he goes with their release weight. I'll just keep it away from the engines. You can bring it over to your side now. So Andrew, talk us through how you're going to use the weight while the fish is plummeting.
With these guys, usually let them down about 50 metres.
Yeah, 50, all that far, 60
metres. Get them down a fair way.
And of course you can tell that.
Just use them with a colour.
Yeah, yeah. And how many metres is each colour?
It's 10 metres a colour.
So you're about 40-ish. Now this gets all of the air out of the fish.
He's off.
He's now released and gone. Eco Sambo fishing. As eco fishing as fishing gets.
Well, that was easy, but after the break, things head south pretty quickly.
Seriola hippos, Samsonfish. Doesn't matter if you use the scientific name or the common name, it adds up to one thing, and that's raw power. That's why I love these fish, and Southwest WA has more of them than anywhere else in the world. The schools have thousands, sometimes tens of thousands of fish in them, and putting a jig through the middle of that means, well, it's almost like shooting a fish in the barrel. To hook one, but landing them, that's a completely different ball game. And sure, you know, they're terrible to eat. But when they fight like this, why wouldn't you want to catch a Samsonfish almost every time you went fishing? Andrew, that was a very nice fish to start. It certainly wasn't small, but we've got totally different gear. You've gone for a really stiff backbone rod and basically just a fluoro knife jig. I've got an overhead as well. I really like my Pen 975 lever drag. It's nice and light and it works well with this rod. Now, two things that are different between our rigs. The first thing is you've got Dacron, haven't you?
Yep.
And that is the standard. Problem is, of course, if you lose that lure to a fish, goes and puts you on a wreck, that's it, end of lure. But if my fish puts me on a wreck, it's not going to happen always, and in fact, it very rarely does. I've just got 60-pound Pen 10X to a 7.0 hoodlum hook and a 300-gram knife jig on an 80-pound leader. Now, the reason I use a lighter hook is because if the fish busts me up, there's 10,000 more down there, isn't there?
Exactly.
And you don't have to go to the trouble of releasing them and getting them to come up right through all those pressure zones. So if he gets off, he gets off. I tie another hoodlum on and I'm done. And the final thing you're going to see is my rod, which is really different. We'll talk you through that once we start fishing. Now, whereas Andrew, he actually uses 80-pound braid, I'm only using 30. And the reason is I'm going to fish them soft. Samsonfish, especially big ones, tend to go very hard. And I want to ease it in for an easy release and an easier fight, but it's still going to be fun. That would be easy bottom.
Now, just heading over the school now.
Okay. Now, I'm not going to give it a lot of rip. So I'm going to show you that you can hook Samson fish very easily. And there you go. I was on there straight away. That had a lot of rips. And I was almost on again. You really don't need to do much. See, that's as easy as it is to hook Samson fish. It doesn't require you acting like Arnold Schwarzenegger at the gym. However, this is where the gym does come in handy. The first burning run. Oh, okay. Now, you'll see now the stretch in my 24 kilo braid buster. Look at that, it's bending right through in a nice arc. The fish isn't freaking out. I learned this on Giant Trevally. Be gentle. If possible, I actually use mono because it gives you stretch, but in lieu of that, a nice bendy rod with a 24 kilo strong butt, not some weak thing. That's exactly what you want. Braid busters are the perfect tool for the job. Now, I know I've got 60 pound leaders to the hook and an 80 pound leader to my 30 pound braid. That's just for abrasion resistance. This really isn't that hard. It's fun, but it's not taxing me. The rod's doing the work. Oh! I lost my hook. But that's all right, there's tons of fish down there. We'll just tie another one. So I've replaced the hook, kept the same jig, back into it straight away. How's the school, Paul? Once again, we're not gonna go stupid on them. If you're gonna fish all day, the more you do this, the less you'll get. But sometimes you really have to go hard. Don't get me wrong. If the fish are being spooky, I'll show you the technique. If they're really not feeding and they're really not interested, sometimes you just, oh, I'm on. They're hitting it through the school. Sometimes you have to go like this. But short jerks. And then you're on straight away. Oh yeah. It's so lucky to have a fishery like this. And no, they're not good to eat. So why do we catch them? Well, because of a bend in a 24 kilo rod like that. That's why we do it. And I'll just buckle up and settle in for a long one. Whoa. Woo. Ah, this is the fun stuff. This is actually a reasonable fish, but I'm not gonna go hard. Just let the rod do the work, tire him out, let him know you're boss, you're in charge. Sort of. I might get spooled here. This is a big fish. Ah, come on. Oh, he dropped the jig.
Every now and then you can see.
I've got another one. It's all right. It doesn't matter if they get off. It doesn't bother me. This isn't quite as big. So I might have to use it to break my duck. Or maybe it is. Who wants to go to the northwest?
It would seem that my 10 to 15 kilo fish had all turned 25 kilos plus. And after the break, we'll try and stop them. Okay, so let's look one more time at a simple jigging technique that'll work almost every time for you. I like to stop the line with my thumb every few metres to create a wounded bait fish look. And remember, we're fishing 100 metres plus here, so allowing for the drift of the boat and the current, you'll need at least a 300 gram lure to get down to the bottom without a huge angle or slope on your line. It's a long way down, but when the eagle has landed, start your jigging and wind hard so you don't create any slack line. Then you've got yourself a sambo. It's every man for himself now.
When we last left our Samson fish, he was doing this. He's still doing it. Good fish, this one. Might not be big, but he's at his Weet-Bix. Or her. I've known some feisty women in my time. Not least of which my wife. Hello, if you're watching. I know you're not. Oh, you must be joking. Ah! Oh, not you. That's all right. He's even closer to the top. I seem to have dropped a big one and hooked a bigger one. How'd I do that? Now, at this point in the fight, it's really important that you don't just panic. This is obviously a big fish, and it's going to tire quicker than I am with all that weight on it. So just have patience. Give yourself 5 minutes to just feel the battle out. Just like Muhammad and his rope-a-dope, we're going to fool this sambo into thinking he's getting away. Small victory, small loss. Damn. Now you may be wondering, if you look down here, about my choice of footwear today, and while we've got a minute, I'll tell you a small story. A few years ago, of course, while I was single, I bought these shoes thinking they looked fantastic on me, and after wearing them once, I realised I indeed did look like a knob. So they are very grippy, and they're good for boating now. Look, at least I haven't got gloves on. With a rod having that curve and bend, it stops the fish from freaking out completely. Normally it's no problem, but today, whoa, it's going again. Today we're in a patch of some big Samson fish, and none of them really want to play ball.
It's coming up.
Oh no.
It's going down.
I got a bad feeling about this. Oh no, you're a sambo still. I thought he might have miraculously changed into a shark. I hate it when they do that.
Well, in fact, this fish was eaten by a shark, probably a big bronze whaler. 30 pounds doesn't look so good now, smart guy, does it? Andrew knew it, I knew it, it was a shark. And this is when the light tackle really bites you on the backside. But we never give up.
It wants to run, but it's tired, so gonna give it the left, right, and then up. Ah, see, I didn't account for the down. Wow, this is a hell of a battle. This is what it's all about. Man versus fish. Versus lack of pre-season training, I think. Oh no. Nah, you're coming. Oh no! Choking me.
Well, the inevitable happened, so what can we do now the sharks were here? Five-way hookup?
Tell you what, mate. These fish today are the biggest I've seen on this particular spot for a while. I'm gonna go to the marlin gear just about, but I wasn't gonna hit them on the head with a spanner. Is that your plan?
That's my plan.
Are you serious? You're gonna drop that down?
22 mil.
Oh, you see, I've always said for Samson fish, you can't hunt a mana grana spanner. You're crazy. You can see a fish over that side of the boat with your spanner. I'll be over here and we'll see which one works best. But I'll tell you what, I've had enough of a little gear. Let's see what they think of this. It's coming up. I'm sick of it.
All jokes aside, this was going to be a good test with three experienced anglers, two bunnies, and a multitude of gear, including a 22-inch ring spanner that's hook was attached with a key ring. What could possibly go wrong?
Here we go. We got five lines in the water because this Leisure Cat 9 meter is about the size of a small oar platform. So five of us at every point to the compass. And I'm going for stretchy mono this time because I'll show you the difference if I can hook one.
Greeny was the first one up and his 24 kilo gear was being tortured from the get-go.
Oh, I'm on two on the way down. I got a hookup and a backlash. That's not fair. And now I'm engaged. Right, you. See you like the marlin gear. Oh, they've got off. On the way down, well, I had a backlash, eh? You gotta love this. Oh, I'm on again. I'm off again. Come on.
You see how much harder it is to hook these fish using mono with any stretch, but the fight should be loads easier. Matt didn't last 5 seconds.
How's the spanner going over there, Andrew?
I'm on.
You're on? Oh, four-way hookup. Is there anything better? It's chaos. Oh,
Whoa. Boy.
Wow, you got smoked. Oh, I'm glad I'm not the only one that's getting blitzed. There's some big fish on this lump today.
Up next, can we actually land one of these four fish? Well, so far you've seen our highs and some of the brutal lows of the day. But a half-hour show doesn't do the mayhem justice. So anyway, let's go catch some Samson fish. And watch out for the only other fish we managed to get the boga grips into for the day.
Now, Andrew, don't lose that fish. It might be the only fish we see.
If this looks like fun and you have a boat, you can get Samson fish lessons from us and others. But what you're really looking for, no doubt, is the results from our day of much larger than expected sambos. 30-pound braid or high-quality mono is okay, and you'll land a bunch of fish, but you will lose jigs unless you try my cheeky little hook trick. Well, you might even lose a few then. I prefer mono to fight the fish, but jigging is much easier with braid. You'll also fit heaps more braid on your spool to fish deeper water, and remember, 100 metres is pretty normal to fish in, so you'll need at least 200, probably more. Overheads versus spinning reels? Well, don't think you have to spend $1,000 on a reel to go jigging. I use pen slammers and spin fishers, and they're well under 300 Australian. Having said that, my Shimano Tynos lever drag was not much more than that, and it's really nice to use as well. And maybe one of those gimbal belt thingies to stop your wedding tackle feeling like mine the next morning. I'm not looking forward to 40.
You just got to remember that you can come jigging for a few bucks, even if you can only afford spanners as lures.
I'd also like to add that this 9-metre leisure cat was some kind of boat to fish from. Not only was it like fishing from a jetty most of the day, on the way home it was rough, and we kept up with Oceanic, the high-speed ferry back from Rottnest Island.
I've just got 60-pound Pen 10X to a 7-0 hoodlum hook.
Look at that swirl of sounder, that is at least 30 to 50 metres deep.
If you're serious about your jigging, and you want to fish 200, even 300 metres of water for big fish, you're going to need 80-pound line and some serious tackle, including Dacron to your hooks. But if you want to have some fun, with about $400 worth of tackle, you can land some big Samson fish and any number of other fish by jigging. Just don't expect to land many when massive whalers not only eat your fish, they also eat your jigs on the way to the bottom.
It's all up to me. Two, come on, there's two hawks. You've got to at least stay on one of them. And there we go. Now, the million-dollar question is, will we ever find out which hook this fish is on? No.
Down.
Bing.
Come on, you know you want to.
Alright. You've stuffed around all morning, that's my turn.
That is true. I do love to see someone else suffering.
Oh, I'm suffering.
I can tell. You've almost hooked as many as me today. And our score's the same. Nil.
I'm gonna tag team.
Screw that. Have a nice day. This. Who wants to play with a Samson fish for a while? I'm starting to sweat.
Let's make sure we get it to the top.
Thanks for that. Smart ass.
How to Catch a Fish was brought to you by Leisure Cat Boats.